welcome to Oxford. Bem-vindo. And asante sana.
I always say it's a chain of life. You young people, you are confronted with the challenges of your times, but there have been other generations behind you. And it's important that we have this kind of interaction in which we learn from you, but also we can provide you with our experience simply as a reference so that you can make your own choices. You can decide what you want to do, how you want to do, how do you want to shape your life, to shape societies in which you live. But that chain of life has to be kept. It's not like, I mean, fragmented history works like a river, it's a flow. So I'm part of those who have been there before you, and I have an immense pleasure of really talking to young people as a learning process, an enrichment process for me.
To be discussing issues that are pertinent to Africa, the innovation fair in particular, seeing all the exciting social impact projects that Africans are developing to solve their solutions, their issues, is deeply gratifying.
One thing which I've picked up from a lot of the work that I've done here over the years is that when you're trying to make fundamental change, you can't make that change in an incremental way. It has to be a step change. And that was sort of very much reinforced in what I've heard in the conference today.
We've been working on this for about 8 months, and it's nice to actually see everything come together. I feel kind of in between, like I'm happy and melancholic at the same time because the team was amazing. And I mean, the day today, it was intense, but the speakers we had, the guests, the delegates, it was just vibrant, inspiring, innovative.
There is making history and writing history. So your task, you the young people, is to do both. You write the history of what your forefathers have done, and then make history, because the next 3 decades will be crucial for the continent. This is how the demographic dynamics will play themselves out. Up to that point when Africa is a workforce of probably 2 billion people and a workforce of just under 1 billion. That would be a crucial issue for your generation. And so I do think that please do write the history. We can help you do that. But above all, make the history. And I think that is the challenge which only you can do.
I think the Oxford Africa Conference is really about conveying to our guests and our delegates and our speakers that ideas matter, and that sometimes it's more important to think about what we do than to act right away. And we have this tendency to jump into solutions and to think of frameworks, but maybe it's time to sometimes step back and you know, emphasize that we need to talk about these ideas and come to answers together.
All of you are really full of energy, and this is a critical and important aspect of what Africa will become in the next 20 years.
I feel really proud of my team. We've come a really long way in 8 months, and so many ups and downs, speaker cancellations, and then getting some really awesome replacements. But we pulled this together, so I'm really, really proud of my team.
I was so happy to see how much better it gets every single year. To see that every single year we're learning and we're bringing even more interesting people, and we're creating the kind of variety that we need to make this a conference that's meaningful for every single person that attends. That's what I love about this conference.
Makoro koto, makoro koto.